I want to be holy. I have a close friend. He takes care of me financially. He's a close friend. He teaches me. He teaches maybe so many things, music, so many things for my students. He's helpful in so many ways. But only one evil habit. What is the evil habit? He's a drunkard. So, when he is drunk, when he drinks, we don't know. Drinks, we do not know. When he is drunk, he talks all filthy language. In a holy place, in a house, in a family, if the father of the home is talking filthy language, he doesn't know because he is drunk. Can we keep him as our friend? Oh, he is my friend to all the villages in the street. Please don't bother. He is my friend. So he is speaking evil. He is talking filthy language. No. The villages will say, if you have to be here, throw away this fellow away. Otherwise, we will finish him off. What does he think? Standing in the street, speaking all filthy language, throw him away. Yes, if you desire the Lord, you have to choose him. Means you have to cast away, you have to throw away, you have to cut off away all that doesn't lead you to God, all that becomes obstacle to desire God. Ask the Lord, get inside the deep of you. The first thing the Lord says, those who wish to follow me. Yes, Lord, I too want to follow you. But if I have to follow you, you demand that I should have the wish, I should have the desire, I should have the longing for you. I should choose you. Choosing you means throw away something which is not of thine. I have to throw away that which doesn't allow me that you grow in me. For you to grow in me, for you to become big in me, there are so many obstacles, so many people. I have to cut them off that I may freely grow. When the plant grows, small plant comes near that. And the big plant has already given its banana. Now what we need to do? Oh, this was so big banana tree. It gave so much of bananas to us. Once upon a time it helped us. So we will keep the banana tree. It will eat up everything which the small plant is supposed to get. So what we need to do? Cut off that big and throw it away. And then the small plant will grow bigger and bigger and give a huge branch of bananas. Desiring God demands hating that which do not allow you to grow in God. Cutting off those relationships, those way of life, those habits, those way of talking away from God, that we may follow him. With the thorny bushes, you can't walk faster. Even though you have a shoe, thorny bushes are thorny bushes. You have to cut them off. God wants you to follow him. And to follow him, you have to desire him. Desiring him demands choosing him. Choosing him means throw away all that is not of God. The second thing Jesus says is, those who wish to follow me, take up your cross. What is this cross? Cross is a symbol of salvation. Cross is symbol of doing the will of the Father. Jesus came for that purpose, to die on the cross. So cross means it is an instrument of salvation. Cross means doing the will of the Father. Yes. The Father kept Jesus not in India, not in America, where you have plenty of people to adore him. Jesus has not come to find fans. Jesus has come to find followers. He did not come to have thousands and millions of fans who can tell Jesus, you are a handsome guy. Jesus, you can do miracles. Zindabad. Sorry, he didn't come. He has not come to collect fans. Not this fan. I'm saying the fans. He has come to receive the followers. So Jesus says, take up the cross. Jesus took the cross. What type of cross he took? We read in the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 7 to 9. Though he was in the glory, because he wants to accomplish what the Father wanted him to do, he threw away the glory of heaven. What is the meaning of taking up the cross? He threw away the glory. Second, taking up the cross means the mighty God, all-powerful God, became an ordinary man who can be killed by people. Taking up the cross means what? Doing the will of the Father means what? He became a man for you and for me. Number three, taking up the cross means doing the will of the Father means he not only became man, he became a servant. He began to serve people. He went around healing people. He went around walking with the people. He went around healing the people. And he took the feet of the disciples, started to wash and kiss those feet. God of heaven and the earth, doing the will of the Father. Taking up the cross means he committed for the life which the Father wanted him to do. Not only that, taking up the cross, doing the will of the Father means allowing the desire of the Father to be fulfilled in his life. The Father wanted him to become like a lamb, to be killed, to go through humiliation, to being forsaken by the people, denied by his own followers, humiliated, spat over, scourged, and to carry the heavy cross, unable to carry, and fall on the mountains, till the end be humiliated. Taking up the cross means all that matters. Today, many desire to follow Jesus. Very few follow Christ. Because today following Christ means a wrong theology is given. Coming to God means receiving healing. Coming to Christ means life without problem. Coming to Christ means life without any sickness. When you come to Christ, all your sickness go away, all your financial problem go away, all that is troubles are going away. Coming to Christ means enjoy, having pleasure, having comfort, having no obstacle. But if we look at Jesus, we understand following Jesus, following the Father means taking up the cross means it is the joy is not in the absence of problem, but it is found in the presence of the Father, the presence of the presence.